Hello friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, I am going to give you the common format which is to be followed by each and every resume. Okay, so let's start. First, the first in the resume, you need to mention contact details. Okay, contact details means your personal details such as your name, your phone number, email address, residential address, permanent address, and your father name. Your father name is optional, okay? Your parent details is optional, but coming to parent, it's better only to mention father's name. Okay, it looks professional. Okay, next profile. Okay, after contact details, you need to mention your profile. Okay, coming to profile, first mention your career objective. Coming to career objective, what is career objective? I'll explain you. Okay, what is career objective? Like they will try to know what would you like to become, like where you want yourself to be after 5 years. Okay, just to estimate your mindset. Okay, so mention your career objective, like I want to be a manager of a same company, or I want to, you know, if you have any real-time goals, okay, just mention them under career objective. Okay, next, qualifications. After, see, first you are mentioning your contact details or personal details. Okay, next you are mentioning your career objectives. Next, mention your qualifications. Qualifications are nothing but educational qualifications. Coming to educational qualifications, most of the students will do the mistake by mentioning, first they'll mention the marks of their 10th, next intermediate, next they'll start mentioning UG marks and PG marks. Okay, this is completely wrong. Okay, you should never do like this. Always start mentioning the marks with your recent qualification, like it may be UG or PG. Next UG, next intermediate, next 10th marks. Okay, like this, in this format you should follow. Why? Because see, HR will have hundreds and thousands of resumes with him or her. Okay, they'll not have time to go through each and every qualification. Okay, they'll just wanted to know your recent qualification to decide whether you are suitable for the job or not. Okay, so that's why always try to mention your PG, like UG or PG, which is recent qualification, that you need to mention first. Next come to the lower qualifications, like this, like chronological order. Okay, next, if you have any experience, okay, if you have any job relevant experience or any other experience, if you are an experienced person, obviously you're going to have an experience, then mention it. Okay, and mention the company details, why did you quit from that company. All these questions will be asked from the HR, so be prepared for all those questions. Okay, and if you are a fresher, you need not mention your experience, because you are a fresher, you'll not have any kind of experience. So if you are a fresher, you will not have to mention this experience. Okay, next, skills and achievements. Okay, achievements and skills. Coming to achievements and skills, list them in an order. Okay, like this. And if you have any special skill, or if you have any special achievement, like I'm an NSS candidate, okay, then highlight it with double quotations so that HR can easily see that point and it will be an added advantage. Okay, so always mention your skills and achievements clearly and make sure you highlight them in double quotations. Okay, if you have any awards also, you can mention them. Okay, next. Certifications, if any. Okay, example, if you are a computer science student and if you have done a certification course in Java, then mention the certification course. When have you done, where have you done, all these details are not required, but mention that you have done a certification course on Java. Like in Java also there are two types of Java, core Java, advanced Java. On which Java you have done the certification, mention it very clearly. I have done certification course on core Java in so and so year. Okay, like this clearly. If you want, you can even mention from where you have got the certificate also, you can mention. Okay, so be clear. Okay, next, be specific. This is a tip. Okay, this is a tip. This is so much important tip. Why I have written it at last, because this is an important tip. I'll explain you with an example why to be specific. Okay, if this is a resume, okay, if they asked you about personal details. Personal means person, means only you. Okay, just mention your details. Don't go like your name, your father's name, your mobile phone number, all that details. Don't go so deep. Okay, like what is your father's job, what is your hometown. These are all unrelated and irrelevant things for the HR. What will HR do knowing your hometown? What will HR do knowing your father's job? Okay, these are all irrelevant things. Always try to be specific and to the point coming to a resume, because HR will spend not more than half a minute in reading your resume. Okay, if you start dragging the points and if you make your resume, the chances of getting a job will be reduced. Okay, so always make sure you'll never ever mention irrelevant points in the resume and make it short and sweet. And thank you so much for watching this video. This is the common format for every resume for a job. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon to get more video notifications from Best Way to Study. Thank you.